All right. And with that, we'll go ahead and move on to our next topic. And what is that going to be, Carlos?
That is our latest entry into the Star Wars universe, Ahsoka. Ahsoka has 4 episodes out as of right now.
Out of 8. So it's half done.
Out of 8, so we're halfway done. Which I gotta say, last 2 nights ago when I was watching the 4th episode, I did have to stop and ask, like, please don't tell me it's 6 episodes. I was very happy to hear that it's 8. What are your thoughts? What do you think? What are you thinking about the show?
Ahsoka, it's all right.
You think it's all right?
It's all right. Okay. I think it's all right. But the problem I have with this show is that, one, I don't think the first episode nearly put me to sleep. I don't think, besides when the 2 like Sith people showed up, I was bored as fuck.
Really?
Okay. Because like I feel like this show, it's made for someone like me. But if I'm only enjoying it to a certain extent, because I'm at a solid like 6.57. And this is Ahsoka. Ahsoka is one of my favorite characters. One of the best things that has ever come out of the Star Wars universe.
Okay.
In the last 10 years. She's a little boring. I find her a little boring right now.
You find Ahsoka boring.
She's a little boring right now. She's doing the whole Master Jedi thing. And I'm like, It's cool, it's all right. But the Master Jedi thing needs to be juxtaposed with something else to really make it, to elevate it to something more. Right. I think they may do that eventually, but right now, it doesn't really work for me. The second thing is, this show feels like it's lacking in sort of like an emotional thread, really. Because I know that we have the whole past with the Rebels, with Ezra, right? And I think this may be one of the mistakes of the show, right? They're trying to like tie in all these properties into something a little more cohesive. But like for me, who sort of I've watched the shows, but I haven't watched them all through like all in one go, right? So things are a little scattered for me.
Okay,
like I had to Google shit.
Right. Okay. So that, I'm gonna pause you right there.
Yeah.
So you've seen all of Rebels?
No.
Just parts.
Just parts.
Okay. Cool. Because that is my same issue, but I don't find it to be an issue. I've never seen anything from Rebels. I never seen Rebels, Resistance, or The Bad Batch, and this show has made me feel like a bad Star Wars fan. Makes me feel like, what have I been doing with all this time? Like, I never even finished Clone Wars. So,
oh, really?
Yeah. So, again, bad fan. I'm, as a person who is very, if you haven't seen all 22 movies of the MCU, get your ass out of Endgame. it feels very weird for me to say, no, I haven't seen that. I've seen all the movies. I mean, that's easy. But in most of the shows, except for those. Though, besides those 4 that I named, I haven't seen any of those. So, a lot of these things that are happening, I don't know what's happening. Besides just general knowledge of what I've seen online. I've seen clips. I've seen this and that. I know about the Trinity.
But you don't think that's an issue as a TV show?
I think so.
Because people are going to check out, dude.
Yeah. I think so. Because I don't think anybody will react like me where I feel shame for not watching, for not understanding, for needing to Google. I think most people, 10 out of 10 people, will say, screw this show. Why am I going to watch this?
Yeah, definitely. You're gonna
if
check
it's,
out.
I needed to watch this, and that to watch this. Because it really just feels like a live action season of Rebels. It doesn't feel like Ahsoka, the show. But I am enjoying it. So continue with your.
Yeah, the thing is, I'm enjoying it to a certain extent. It's just like, once again, Star Wars feels stuck. It feels stuck. Like, you have an opportunity here to tell a story about Ahsoka, and you're adding all these additional auxiliary things that don't feel like, hey, maybe, okay, you know what I like? The whole idea of Ahsoka having an apprentice, right?
Yeah.
if I know exactly what the fuck you're gonna do with this, then what's the point?
Right.
I don't. If I know exactly what you're gonna do as a writer, then what's the point? It's like you don't give a shit. If you don't give a shit, why would I give a shit? Right. If you're going to set up some sort of parallel, make it something worth watching. Right. One of the reasons why I got so frustrated by Star Wars, the sequel trilogy, is that they set up this amazing villain in Kylo Ren, killed his own father, committed genocide, killed a whole bunch of planets. And then they spent the next two movies trying to fucking redeem him.
Yeah.
When in the very first movie you made it clear he shouldn't be redeemed. And I'm like, and I see this sort of same pattern where like they're stuck on the decisions that they've made the last 20 years in Star Wars. Always about Sis, always about this, always about that. And we're never going into a new direction. Right, the one thing I really like about this show, that keeps me watching every week, is the idea of Admiral Thrawn. This guy better fuck me up. And what I'm telling you, if this guy doesn't scare the shit out of me, if he doesn't cause some deaths, if he doesn't like shake the foundations of the fucking galaxy, then I don't want it.
Right.
Like, we need a new direction. And I think I have a theory. Give me a second.
Okay. I'm following.
So I have a theory. So I think what they're doing, the reason why they've integrated these sort of rebel characters from the animated parts of the IP, is that they're finally trying to do something that's trying to do a villain in a Thanos-like fashion.
Okay.
Right? And I think the fact that they've teased Admiral Thrawn like this is what I think really works, especially in the, you know what I really like? That first scene where Ahsoka didn't speak, she was just kind of gazing, understanding, and figuring out the thing. I thought that was a really well done scene. I thought that was a perfect scene. But what I think they're trying to do is, especially with the Mandalorian, especially with how it ended, right? The last season, they're trying to make a sort of cohesive understanding of the timeline before we finally get into this idea of someone who the entirety of what we understand as our heroes and our main people can focus on. Because the First Order bullshit didn't work, right? We do not care about the First Order anymore. No one does.
You can't, because you delegitimized Kylo Ren and Snoke.
Exactly. So we are going into a direction, I really hope they do this, where Admiral Thrawn is the focus. And if Ahsoka can do that, then I think it will be a worthwhile show that may not, to me, have started out great, but has an opportunity to finish really well, to induce some excitement into the Star Wars universe. Because think about it, where are we going? What are we doing? What is the point of all this? Like, what are we heading towards? Because like, they can exchange Sith and Jedi and all this crap and Empire all they want, but ultimately we need to see a vision for us to be excited as fans, right? That's why we're having trouble with the Marvel Cinematic Universe right now. The vision is not cohesive, it's not coherent. So if they can finish that off, and one more thing I have to mention, right? Star Wars universe needs to get over the fucking Skywalkers. I'm sorry, I love Anakin. I love Luke, but Rey going, I'm Luke, Rey Skywalker at the end, was so fucking stupid. Like, no one gives a shit. He was like the son of slaves. No one gives a shit about the Skywalker name anymore.
Yeah.
But him, like, what was it? That final episode where, what was it? Anakin appears.
Like, from my understanding, from what my brother has Googled and informed me, because again, we have to Google, they're in the world between worlds.
Okay. That makes sense a little bit, but stop trying to appeal to nostalgia. You've done it too much. You've done it in The Mandalorian. You've done it in shows and movies.
And Obi-Wan.
In Obi-Wan. Like, enough is enough. Like, you're so scared of doing something worthwhile that when somebody does do it, like The Last Jedi, you will accept the stupidest things ever. Right? Because the problem isn't that The Last Jedi did something new, was that they did something bad, you know? Yeah. But enough trying to appeal to nostalgia. Give us new things to cheer on about, right? Because they did it in The Mandalorian. I love the characters in The Mandalorian.
Right.
But hold on to that. Their riskiest idea. The Mandalorian was the riskiest thing they ever did.
Yes.
Right? And it's super successful. Give us more of that.
It's their best offering.
Yeah.
In the past 6-7 years.
Probably longer. But that's what I'm saying.
Okay, let's say since The Force Awakens to now,
oh, yeah,
The Mandalorian is the best offering.
Yeah. I mean, I would say so. So, like, step out of their own way. The Star Wars franchise IP is rich enough to give yourself some leeway to not just rely on those things. I'm a fan, but it's not 2001 anymore. Come on.
I guess I'm seeing everything you're saying now, because while I have thought there's been cool aspects about Ahsoka, you're absolutely right. Nothing has really happened. So, like, I don't even have an argument for you. Usually, you know, I'm going to be the one to try to defend the show. But at the same time, it does take a lot, because I don't know who any of these people are.
The emotional tether is not
I don't have an emotional tether. All I know is that they're important. That's really all I know. Like, Sabine, I think Sabine is a cool character.
Yeah, me too.
I think that Sabine is witty. I think she's funny. I like seeing her, as opposed to Ahsoka, who I have known to be basically a wild child.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
That's what Ahsoka is. And now we have this, like, calm Ahsoka who doesn't really do anything.
Is it boring?
Because my favorite scenes are when she does something.
Yeah, exactly. You know,
that's that scene where she pops out of the window and drops down and starts fighting that guy, like, whoever that is. Which, again, doesn't matter now after episode 4, because he's dusted to smithereens.
Yeah.
That
was so disappointing.
Or the scene where Ahsoka, well, it was something that she did. That space battle, yeah, where she pops out of the ship. I thought it was just the better version of what Leia did in The Last Jedi. You know, make it make sense. Like, yeah, okay, she's in a suit. She's going to flip around. I thought it was cool. So, but I don't really know why Sabine matters.
Nah, no worries. It's the... And I mean, to be honest, that's a problem I have. I feel like I know what they're gonna do with Sabine, you know, especially when they're designing things like this, they often have a direction, and if you feel like you can see it, that's a problem. At least to me.
I also don't have any emotional attachment to Ezra, because I never watched the show. I know who he is. I know what he's done. I know certain things. I know certain things, but, like, it doesn't really matter to me.
Imagine a casual Star Wars fan.
So then you get to the main problem, the problem you're highlighting, which is we need to go somewhere cool with this, with Thrawn. How do you do that if we know Thrawn comes in the next 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, in Star Wars time, we get to the First Order? Isn't this post, like, when does the show take place? Post episode 6, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So in between episode 6 and 7. You know where we end up. How does Thrawn become this master villain if we know he's nowhere to be seen in those movies?
I saw a video, which I think is perfect. One, a galaxy is a pretty damn big place.
You're getting to where I think we're going. So,
you know,
share your thoughts.
The main thing is we didn't really. One of the problems with the First Order is we didn't understand its scope. We didn't really know its origins or how wide things were, right? So maybe they're just not that large. They're just not that big. They're kind of this, you know, goofy little upstart empire thing that they were trying to go for. So maybe that can be. I think that if with some effort and some creativity, the First Order can be explained away or pushed aside. Look, no one would have a problem with it. I wouldn't have a problem with it. I think most casual fans would not have a problem with it. but I think it can be pushed to the side a little bit, and essentially we can operate on another side of the galaxy. Like I said, it's a pretty big place, and I think that's the direction they need to go on, because god damn it, I'm tired of that first order bullshit.
Okay. Isn't Starkiller Base larger than the Death Star?
True.
That's where I think about scope. And then I think about, well, when you go to Hollywood Studios in Disney World, you're on a planet, and the stormtroopers that are walking around are First Order with Kylo Ren. You're not looking at Empire stormtroopers. So I'm thinking about Disney not being able to take away just as a business. But what I think is truly going to be the thing that happens, that can happen, is we actually, instead of moving towards Thrawn being this villain of this galaxy, I think what it's alluding to, and I'm sorry to everybody that's listening right now, because I'm having the worst hiccup attack ever. So I promise to never have bacon before this show again. But what I think is going to happen is, you know, these whales that can travel and all this space-time continuum stuff that they're going into, this map, I think we're finally going to be able to see them go to a different universe.
Oh, really?
Because they're doing all this stuff to say, we're going to get Thrawn and Ezra from wherever they are, right? Because that's what happens in Rebels. He sends him, Ezra saves the universe by sending himself and Thrawn somewhere else. We know that this map that they're looking for is for a highway, a way to get from our galaxy to the next galaxy to come back. We know that galaxy to galaxy travel is uncommon because they've built this whole ship. They've never seen any hypergalactic speed, hyperspace ship. This is odd. So let's go from galaxy to galaxy. We know that the whales that we see when they fly into that planet, and the whales that are in the post credits, art, whatever you want to call that, it shows those whales. So there's something to being able to travel from one galaxy to the next, having to go on those highways or those paths, whatever, that map. There's something to this world between worlds, which apparently exists outside of space, time, and continuum, and whatever. It's not this highway. I think where you go is, have we depleted everything we needed to do in this universe right now, and go to another galaxy? Start there. That's and maybe fresh. See what's there, and maybe send key characters there to get stuck.
I would love that.
Because then you open yourself up to what Marvel is trying to do with the multiverse, except for you don't go multiverse, you just go galaxy.
Much better. New aliens, new conflicts.
You don't know what's out there, and you don't know how common these things are. You don't know what's out there. We never thought about this. And the reason I even think all of this is because one of the first things that I saw when the show came out, and I still hadn't watched like the first three episodes, was that Star Wars changed this lifelong big thing. And I was like, what did they change? I didn't even read the article. But as soon as I started the first episode, I saw it. The crawl.
Oh, yeah. That was a little...
First, the crawl was in red. First of all, we never got in a crawl for a non-movie.
Yeah, that was what I noticed. That was...
We've never gotten a crawl on any other show. But the second thing is, the crawl didn't start with a long time ago in the...
I don't know why I didn't pick up on that, but you're right.
So why are we putting all this focus on galaxy to galaxy? It's never come up. This has never come up. We've always talked about, you know, the outer rim, the inner rim, Coruscant, this vast land of power, like the where the Kessel Run is. Like, this map has been established, but we've never talked about galaxy to galaxy. I think that's where you go.
That would be perfect. In an instant, that would give a whole new vision to the Star Wars universe.
And then you leave everything canonically what's been done.
Yeah, and you don't have to touch it ever again. Rey Skywalker and do whatever the hell
you don't
want.
You don't have to touch it again. You just... What's out there is out there. explore what else is out.
You know they're making another movie.
Another Star Wars movie? Nah, isn't aren't all the movies on pause?
No, I heard rumors they're making one based on Rey Skywalker. Yeah, with his friend.
I'm gonna watch it, right?
I mean, yeah. I mean,
we're all gonna watch it.
I'm gonna watch it.
Because I would like to see Daisy Ridley again. I feel like I haven't seen her in anything.
With a competent writer. Not for a long time. Not since...
I haven't seen her in anything. So would I want to see Daisy Ridley? Yeah.
Yeah.
Rey Skywalker?
Nah.
I just don't understand. Like, what's the show after Ahsoka? It's gonna be The Acolyte?
Yeah, that's what I heard.
And what is, where is that set? Like, do you even know?
I don't know.
So it's like... I don't know. I mean, where do you really? I am like I said earlier, I am happy. We still have another 4 episodes to go to see more development. I don't now that we have this conversation. I don't know if it's enough time.
I think 4 episodes, considering how the pace of this show. I think 4 episodes.
You think that because I think the pace is slow.
I think the pace is slow, but I think it's clear it's going to pick up. I think this was the point that it was trying to get to.
Yeah.
That's my feeling. If it doesn't, then, oh, Lord.
Yeah, I agree. Well, let me say my favorite parts of the show. When they do fight, I do like the fighting.
Yeah.
I do love Sabine. Love Hu Yang. Awesome. He is so funny. The actual Jedi training scene that they had, I felt like it was really long for that episode, but at the same time it was just awesome to watch.
Yeah.
Hera, love Hera. Love anytime you if you tell me Mary Elizabeth Winstead is gonna be in the show, I'm in there. That's fine. Those are some of my favorite things about the show. I just hope that, you know, we actually get into more. And if Anakin's gonna be in this next episode, which obviously he has to be, I mean, let him be in the episode, let him get in and get out. Yeah. I'm never gonna say no to Hayden Christensen, because the resurgence he's getting from Star Wars fans right now, I think is just owed to him.
Like redemption for the
Star Wars. It is redemption for Star Wars fans, for him, for himself. But we also need to move on.
Yes.
And Thrawn needs to show up in this next episode.
And do something.
He can't just show up at the end in the last 5 minutes, which is probably what's going to end up happening.
Yeah,
bro. He's probably going to show up and the credits are going to roll. And also, we need to use some of this time in the credits. It's been a mighty long time since we've gotten a post-credit scene in any of these Disney Plus shows. It's kind of ridiculous. You kind of owe me. Like,
come on.
You can't just, like, not
tease the
episode. Especially that they don't have trailers for episodes.
Yeah, that's true.
They don't have next week on...
So and so.
Exactly. So you have to show me something.
Yeah. But 4 episodes in, I think there are some things left to be desired. However, it's still a decent show.
Yeah, it's not bad by any means. I mean, at the same time, it's still quality directors, quality actors, quality production, and it looks phenomenal.
Yes, it does.
It looks better than most movies.
Yeah, that's true. As a lot of the Disney Plus Star Wars shows have looked phenomenal.
They've looked phenomenal. The any scene in a ship, any scene in space looks phenomenal. Mm-hmm. So there's no complaints there. Hyperspace looks amazing. They just keep improving it, entity by entity. So I'm definitely excited to see the next 4 episodes. So hoping, you know, we get some action going.
Is there anything else you want to mention about Ahsoka?
Ahsoka? No, man. I want to see this next episode. I mean, I think this next episode is going to be very key. The latter half of the middle. So.
It better be. It better be good.
It's got to be chock full of plot.
Just something.
Yeah, we got to move forward. Definitely. But all right. I think that's all on Ahsoka. So we're definitely going to be talking about it more as these episodes come out. So. Push forward, it's time to make the day yours. Push forward, it's time to make the day yours. See, it's not the cause that life heals, anyone can alter situations. Push forward, it's time to make the day yours, anyone can alter situations. They try to